Ratan Kumar Sen, you know how much time is left for your party? Negative time.
So long I'll speak, negative that's
time.
My time.
Negative time.
So long I'll speak, I think that should be my time. Kindly allow.
So, Sorry, talk five minutes.
I don't like to lose time.
Talk 5 minutes, sir. 5 minutes.
Okay, okay. Thereafter, your consideration. No, actually, I don't like to repeat. I think that very exhaustively, the finance bill has been dealt by our colleagues from both the sides. And one thing that claim is that to make much more financial management, financial governance, much more effective in the interest of growth and development. That is one argument. And the other argument, that never before the constitutional integrity, never before so brazenly compromised, so much trampled underfoot. I think that it is an issue between these two. Now Lok Sabha has passed that. They have a majority, they have passed that. I understand that the basic context on which the rule of majority defining democracy has to be understood, that that has to ensure that the constitutional provisions are not diluted. That is something which no majority can change it. I think on that basis our forefathers have written the constitution, and we are again and again reiterating whenever we take oath in the name of constitution. I think in this finance bill, besides other points to be dealt with, that constitutional integrity is seriously compromised. The finance bill, what should be finance bill, the constitution has clearly defined 101 and 2. That point was ignored, and the number 3 has been taken as a Bible, and everything under the sky has been put which is not even distantly related to the financial matters of the government. Can any reply to these ever exist? You are changing the tribunal system altogether and taking, you are giving a quasi-judicial structure which should remain at arm's length from the executive. You have taken our entire power on you, and you are violating the basic spirit of defense of our constitution, that is the separation of power between the executive and the judiciary. And what are those tribunals? Though all those tribunals are very basically closely related to the economic and other administrative governance of our country in day-to-day basis. The tribunals are the forum to settle all those grievances and disputes. You have absolutely taken it over, and it is very clear that in most of the tribunal, government is the litigant, and there will be a clear conflict of interest. And that's how a judicial system will be bent backward to serve the interest of the executive. I don't say you have intention to do so, but I definitely say by doing this, you have established, you have allowed, paved the way for such severe political distortion in the whole democratic structure and this constitutional scheme. I think this is, we have done, if I say to be very conservative in my word, that we have committed a big crime to our constitution. I think all conscience must prick ourselves whether we should allow this thing to go, because this signals an ominous danger for the whole democratic system itself, which is based on certain basic provisions which ensures democracy, as well as which stands against any effort of distortion and aberration. If this goes, and this kind of concentration of power, which is quite natural when the whole economic system is under crisis, but if that is allowed by the very system which defends democracy, that signals a danger of authoritarianism taking over the democratic system itself, not only in respect of economics, but also in respect of politics and society. And all those cancerous signals are already raising their head in different ways in the present political system, which alarms us much more. I think on these aspects, the matter, our good sense, all of us, my colleague in this house, should seriously consider some of the issues to be reviewed, and this house must recommend to Lok Sabha. Yes, you have done in your wisdom of majority there. Please reconsider. Certain aspects need to be sent back. Issues have already been discussed. The non-finance related issues to be completely withdrawn from this finance bill. If required, you bring separate bill. And I believe many of the issues of those non-finance issues which you want to address to the finance bill, in many of the issues there are scope, opportunity for a greater consensus. Then why should you take this backdoor method which hits at the trustworthiness between us? Why should you allow that kind of a method? It can let the bill, legislation brought separately, let it be considered, let standing committee go through the process, and let the thing, I think many of the things, there are scope for consensus, irrespective of government and oppositions. But why should you take that backdoor method? I think these are the issues which need to be seriously addressed. I'm just concluding. And on that premise, we have given some amendments are there. I think House will duly consider amendments, not on partisan spirit, but on a spirit that these dangerous trends should not be condoned, should not be allowed. These upper house must seriously consider. I appeal to their conscience. And the another important point, I think, which needs. We are promoting a distortion in the whole economic process, particularly when the situation is gloom, not in our country alone, globally. It requires a push from down below. It requires demand management more than supply management. And I believe our learned friends on the other side, there are many economists are there, they also understand well, but they may have their different other compulsion. The situation demands that people must spend more. The market on which the whole economic system thrives, that market is not allowed to squeeze down. Last 3 years, GDP has increased, but employment has declined in net terms. Please check up your own data. Employment in both manufacturing sector, in service sector, in other economic sector, gone down in net term. What is the requirement of the time? That you must reduce drastically the burden of the indirect tax. Now we are coming to a GST regime, much more straight-jacketed regime. Everything will be decided by
okay.
The please.
Okay.
In this situation, that burden must be reduced. If the increase, so far whatever record
okay,
figure we are seeing as GDP increase, if that is to make a sense of real well-being to the common people, this burden of indirect tax must reduce.
Okay.
The dangerous,
just a minute.
The most dangerous issues, I am just rushing through my points, I am not explaining. The dangerous trend of direct tax GDP ratio, which has come down to a very shameful level of 5.5%, all-time low, which is not permissible in a civilized welfare society, which you yourself claiming it to be. It must be changed. The serious distortion and the imbalance between
please.
The burden of
there
the direct tax and indirect tax, which
speakers.
Is goes against the people,
okay.
must be corrected. And
okay.
finance bill, instead
okay.
of doing backdoor method, unauthorized method, tempering on the integrity of the constitution, instead of doing that thing, the finance bill better concentrate in this area in the greater interest of the people, and on that ground the finance bill need to be returned to Lok Sabha for reconsideration
yes.
and applying their majority within the framework of constitution, not to
okay.
make it
Tabanji,
an outrage of
it,
the entire
you are taking from the negative
thank
time
you,
of
sir.
Your party. It's another wonder.
I am
See, making
so
time from
quickly.
The negative time, from no time. That is only you can do. Now, Sri KT.